Throughout the day, we have reports that come down that tell us exactly how much green coffee we need to roast for the day. So we will go through and pull exactly what coffee bags we need from the shelf and bring them forward to the roasting area to prep for roasting.
To start a roast, we tear open the bag of green coffee and dump it into a trough which feeds a grain elevator. The grain elevator will lift and distribute the coffee into the appropriate roaster. There's a hopper on top of each roaster and a lever that will release that coffee when we feel the time is ready into the actual roasting drum itself. During the roasting process, we'll check the color of the bean using a trier, and it's essentially just sort of our little window into what's happening on the inside. The coffee is roasted essentially by convection heat. It's mostly a fan that pulls the hot air produced by the burners through the drum. And they say about 85% of the heat that's applied to the beans is just that hot air, the convection heat. The other 15% is conduction, and typically it's actually the bean-to-bean contact and not so much contact with the wall of the drum, as that's pretty minimal. It's pretty important to pay attention not just to the visual data, not just to the numbers on the temperature gauges and the time, but also to certain sensory elements like sound and smell. It can actually be very helpful. The first 4 to 5 minutes of a roast involve just drying out the moisture content that's in the beans. There's very little visual change and the temperature stays relatively low through those first couple of minutes. After that period of time, the beans will begin to change color. They'll start to become a little bit yellowish and then progress very quickly through sort of a rainbow of yellows and oranges into the sort of brownish color that you're used to seeing by the time they exit the roaster. Once the coffee's finished, there's two different doors that need to be opened to expunge the coffee from the roaster, and then the coffee is spilled into a cooling tray where a large fan will pull ambient air from the environment to cool the coffee to room temperature, which usually takes around 3 to 4 minutes. Saudades, soluços, eu vou...